My name's Elise Garrick. I'm the president of PTI and the vice president of the IANA functions for ICANN. And my colleague, Marilia Hirano, is our manager for continuous improvement. We're going to tag team this. It won't take a long time, but Marilia has some important information to share, and I'll do the kind of normal stuff. So our agenda today is basically, what is PTI? I know Oscar just said something about it, but it seems like so many people are so confused. And who do you contact? Do you contact ICANN? Do you contact IANA? Do you contact PTI? So we'll try and make that a little clearer. Then Carlos earlier today talked about the DNSSEC root zone key rollover. I'm just going to make an announcement about that and some other announcements about the DNSSEC. Finally, part of the contract that the RIRs have with ICANN is about reporting, so we'll go into that a bit. And then finally, annual third-party activities is Marilia's specialty, and so she'll be telling you about that. So what is PTI? This picture tries to kind of break it down in very simple fashion. Basically, ICANN has a department within it that's called the IANA department. And based on the contracts and the proposals from the community, ICANN had to create an affiliate called PTI, which would perform the IANA functions. So the IANA department gets loaned to this new affiliate to do the IANA functions. So that's it in a very simple schematic. Now, if you look at this picture, you heard that there's a contract between the RIRs and ICANN. Well, that's true. So the RIRs have a contract with ICANN to deliver the numbering function. Then ICANN has a contract with PTI to deliver that operational activity on behalf of ICANN. And then ICANN is responsible for making sure that PTI does its job and that the RIRs are happy. So I hope this simplifies a little bit about the relationship between the RIR community, ICANN, and PTI, and how the IANA services fit into that bit. So the question about, all right, now that we've got ICANN, IANA department, PTI, who do you contact? Basically, if you want to find out about the contracts, governance, the director's agreements, who's on the PTI board, you contact pti.icann.org. All the information's on that website. If you actually want to have some operational service and you want us to do something for you, and you want to see the reports, the operational reports, you still go to the same place, www.iana.org. That's where we keep all of the operational reports. And if you want to send us a question or find out why some information doesn't look the way you think it should look, then you would go to iana@iana.org and ask that question. Now, because we used to be ICANN's department, we still have our ICANN email addresses, but we've created an iana.org email address as an alias, so you can reach all of the staff of PTI/the IANA department at either of those addresses. Some people say, why didn't you use pti.net or pti.org or pti.com? It was taken. We didn't have a choice. Somebody else, other than public technical identifiers, took the PTI algorithm and, or acronym. And we tried to think maybe pti.earth, pti.international, but instead we just stuck with iana.org. And this just shows that still the instructions for how you submit things, and I know most of the people in this room don't submit requests to us. You submit them to your own regional internet registry, LACNIC. But these are the instructions the people who represent you would follow when they would submit requests to us. So this is the announcement part. It's a little bit of a repeat of what you've heard from Carlos and others. We will be replacing the Root Trust Anchor for the first time. It'll become operational. As Carlos mentioned, there'll be two of them in operation at that point in time in October. They'll both be announced. And then the documentation, if you want to find out more about that, the plan, what the steps are, how you get to that test environment. If you want to test your own servers, you can all find it at this URL. The second big announcement about DNSSEC is that we are putting out, or we have put out a call for additional representatives to become a trusted community representative. There are three roles in being a trusted community representative. One of them is a cryptographic officer. One role is just you're in a backup pool in case someone decides to retire from the role. As you can see, somebody retired in 2016 and someone from LACNIC replaced them. But so we'll be putting out a call for more people who are interested in filling this role. And some of the people who've been doing it since 2010 have indicated that they are interested in retiring. I don't know if it's any of the folks from LACNIC. These are only a few of the TCRs. I just thought I'd highlight that your community contributes very highly by volunteering to do this very important role. And if you want more information about what the criteria is to be a trusted community representative, I've put the URL on the slide. If you want to know about all three roles, that's on the slide. And I don't know if any of you ever watch US television, but it's gotten to be kind of a sexy role. It was in one TV show called Blacklist Redemption. And they had this thing about the TCRs, and one of them's kidnapped or killed or something, and how that's going to disrupt the internet. Most of it was all fake, but if you have ever watched the March version of that show, Blacklist Redemption, know that the facility is actually the way it is. You have to have like a retina scan, and two people have to enter at the same time. But anyway, that's the role, the trusted community representative. And it's becoming very popular. It's on TV. So how about reporting? Basically, the contract requested that the IANA functions operator, PTI, through ICANN, start delivering reports 6 months after PTI became an affiliate and doing the IANA functions. This is the first report we submitted, which was in March 2017. We sent it in April because the due date is 15 days after the end of the month that you're reporting on. And as you can see, this is a report that has to do with the automatic allocation of IPv4 addresses from the recovered pool of IPv4 addresses. So we've sent two of these reports, and they say that we're in compliance with the service level agreement that all the RIRs have with ICANN for PTI to deliver the service. This is the most recent report. There were no requests during the month of April, and so therefore, we met all the SLAs because there was nothing for us to do on that point. But we will send the report anyway, and these are published on the IANA.org/performance website. And now I'd like to turn this over to my colleague, Marilia, and she'll tell you about third-party activities.
Boa noite a todos. Como a Elis já disse, eu trabalho com a melhoria contínua do departamento da IANA, agora PTI. E esse trabalho inclui gerenciar duas auditorias. Uma é do sistema que a Elis acabou de mencionar, das cerimônias do QSK. Existem dois auditores que vão lá e testam o procedimento que eles usam. É uma auditoria que a gente usa, que é o SOC 3. O relatório é público, se vocês tiverem interesse em ler, o relatório não é muito comprido, ele está no nosso site, iana.org. A segunda auditoria ela é um pouco mais complexa. Os auditores testam todos os sistemas que a gente usa, o sistema de suporte da Diana e o RZMS, que é o Root Zone Management System, que a gente usa também. A auditoria hoje em dia ela é conduzida pela PwC. A gente vai abrir para consórcio agora. A gente vai mudar os auditores, né, para manter uma continuidade, mas o padrão da auditoria geralmente é mudar depois de 5 anos. Já tem 7 anos que a gente faz o SOC 3, desde a primeira cerimônia de QSK, ela foi auditada, e é o 4º ano que a PwC está fazendo o SOC 2. Então, agora a gente vai abrir aí para outras firmas de auditoria poderem bid. Desculpa que eu estou misturando as duas línguas, mas ler em inglês e falar português é um pouquinho confuso. E aí a outra atividade que a gente terceiriza é a pesquisa de satisfação do cliente. No caso, a gente tem essa pesquisa anual, que é enviada para os CEOs das IRRs e para os Registration Services Managers. A participação média é 37% nos últimos 4 anos, e a satisfação das IRRs é bem alta, 99% de satisfação com o trabalho da Ana. Esse ano a gente está mudando um pouco o formato dessa pesquisa. Os convidados a participar vão ser os mesmos, mas as perguntas vão ser mais direcionadas ao como a gente gerencia o relacionamento com as IRRs, ao invés de mais a parte de customer service, porque o trabalho que a gente faz com as IRRs é mais de engajamento e relacionamento. Então, fiquem atentos que o timeline da pesquisa é setembro. Segunda semana de setembro é quando a gente convida as IRRs para participarem dessa pesquisa. A gente está em fase de planejamento dessa formatação, que a gente está nessa reestruturação da pesquisa. Era isso que eu tinha para anunciar. Se vocês tiverem alguma pergunta, eu estou aqui até sábado de manhã. A Elise também está aqui. A gente está disponível para responder. Obrigada.